Hello and welcome to Minding the Mindset. With me is a luminary, someone who's the people following on all across. Thank you so much and welcome, Mr. Sudhakar Rao. Thank you so much, sir, for being here.
Thank you very much, Dawood, for inviting me and hosting me today. It's my pleasure to be with you on this session.
So it's our honor and privilege. Sir, your journey is impeccable. Director of India's, you know, premium branding institute, IIM Bangalore, your stint with MIT Sloan. Sir, education has been a journey for you. Please tell us more.
Journey of education is equal to the journey of learning. Since learning is continuous and unending, I think we need to keep learning. We need to keep understanding several segments of our society.
Sir, this is wonderful. The best part about you, sir, you're so accessible when we meet you in conferences. And I read a quote that you just uploaded where it says, leaders are those who create real estate spaces in hearts and mind. I'm sure you've done that, sir. How do you manage so much?
That is pretty close to my mindset. And I believe that leaders are those people who increase space on the real estate of their minds and hearts. So leaders are givers. Leaders are the people who nurture others. They develop more leaders. So unless and until they create more space for others to grow, I think they will not be very effective. And those who are not effective are not leaders. So leadership is a function of acceptance, and therefore it sees empathy and it sees a reflection in others' growth. So therefore, leadership is more dynamic, and leadership is something which is very, very interesting as a phenomenon for all of us to study.
Oh, sir. So we have heard leaders are the one who shows the way, knows the way, and goes the way. I'm sure you're one of us. You know, you are someone we really follow in all the way that you show us, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
So in this 15 days and 21 days and a little more of the pandemic, we've seen a complete shift of the schools. You know, technologies have become, Zooms have become very popular. How do you see schools in the 10 years from now as we grow, sir?
Instead of looking at 10 years from now, I think we should look at the immediate first.
Okay.
I believe very strongly when we read certain books in history or when we observe certain, we are also going to change the game. We are also going to change the way we have been functioning, both at the school level as well as higher education level. The schools will be the last one to be opened after the lockdown. Let us take it, even if it is not announced yet.
Okay, this is a
but
bold
schools will be the first one to recover from the learners, or the students, on the other hand, are anyway digital natives. They pick it up very, very fast. Therefore, for institutions at school level as well as at the higher education level, the most important takeaway now is to reorient teachers very, very quickly and make sure that our online academic reputation building, online academic deliveries, online academic effectiveness, and differentiation points, all these will have to be built around very, very quickly. The first 3 months will be a period where we'll do catch up. Most of the schools and colleges and universities will do a catch up in the first 3 months.
Okay.
They settle down and they realize that there's no other option, and we need to actually strengthen our online properties and our abilities to reach students in this generation very, very nicely. So the ability to bring forth all that you have been doing otherwise as a differentiating point and put it very crisply and nicely for the students and communicate the same to their parents and influencers will win the day for them. The lesson that we will always take away from this pandemic is that we will do less of crowding. We will do less of conferencing, physical conferencing. We will do less of traveling. All that will save greater deal of carbon footprint. We will make it carbon negative to a large extent. 3 to 6 months to get these things right. And we'll be limping back to normalcy in 9 months' time from now. That's my prognosis.
Well, so this is one of the most fantastic, transparent, candid, you know, a summary of what we can predict in education industry that I've heard. This is so, so beautiful. In the pandemic, what are the books on your table, sir?
The book on the table for me is Anti-Fragile.
Wow.
This is authored by Taleb, Nassim Nicholas Taleb.
Yes, the Black Swan guy.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. He's my favorite author, and Anti-Fragile is for the current times. Although it has been written some time back,
yes.
there cannot be a more appropriate book for me and the people like me and you to read at this time.
I love the choice of words, sir. The way you know, it's more like poetic to me. The kind of books that you're choosing, the prognosis you suggested. This is so much that we've got used to hearing from you. And I think that's why we flog all your social media accounts and your conferences. I'm coming to my second round, which I call the don't mind it. I call it with fondly the Rajinikanth round. We want to see the other side of Dr. Sudhakar. Sir Sudhakar, so let me ask you first. We saw glimpses of you working inside the house, washing dishes all around. So on a scale of 10, sir, if your spouse were asked how good a spouse you are, what would the rating be?
You wanted me to rate myself, right?
Yes, sir. And we'll get a testimonial, hopefully.
That's a tricky one, but you are known for asking these things. I have only tried dishwashing.
All right, so we saw the pictures.
Yeah, I have only tried dishwashing, nothing great, but I seem to be good at, could be one of the dishwashers or one of the best dishwashers around in my locality, probably. But on a scale of 1 to 10, I'll rate myself as pretty close to 9.
Wow, sir. So we'll get a testimonial from ma'am to you know, attest to this fact.
Properly. I think the armchair brooding or armchair analysis has been too much for us to see around. Right. I thought we should just get into the scene, do something which is going to be useful for at least a few individuals on the ground. Right. So what I did was I spoke to my own classmates. We were a class of 94, College of Engineering at Usmani University. My batchmates, as we are talking, has touched about 30 such pockets. I can tell you from the ground that with best of the intentions, we are not able to reach out to even 1% of them wherever they can. That's my message.
That's so wonderful, sir. This is so commendable that you're leading the way and absolutely fantastic. So are you a morning lark or an evening owl? Or the night owl?
I am a doer.
Okay, this is nice, sir.
I am not a armchair brooder. I am a doer.
Sir, given a choice between becoming a grandmaster at chess or 100 meter Olympic champion, what would you choose?
Any day grandmaster chess.
Wow, I can see the intellect flowing through. That's really interesting.
Maybe my next life.
So if you were an animal, which any animal you could be, which one would you be and why?
I would like to be a camel.
Wow, this is interesting.
I would like to be a camel because camel has displayed its ability to survive. The lessons of instinct for survival for a long, long time in adverse conditions and situations is what a human being is supposed to imbibe.
My last question to you, how does the educationist Sir Sudhakar Rao unwind himself? So what happens? Is it music? Is it Netflix? How does that happen, sir?
I watch a lot of movies. That's been there with me during my undergrad days.
Wow.
When I was in engineering, I used to watch on an average 3.52 movies per week.
That's wonderful.
That was too much. Okay.
So that's a secret of how we become good educators. We're making notes, sir.
Even now I watch a lot of movies on Netflix and Prime Video. So I keep watching. So right now, as we are talking, last night I watched about two movies, Blackmail and Road to Ladakh by Irfan Khan.
Wow, that's a tribute. That's a lovely way of actually doing a tribute, sir, to someone who's amazing.
He's one of the finest actors who has lived in our times.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Thank you so much, sir, for your time. We saw the intellect part of it, the empathetic part of it, the prognosis that you shared, sir. It was amazing just to share my conversation with you. I learned so much. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Dawood, for zeroing on me. I am very happy to have conversed with you. Convey my regards to your family members. And you too have a good time and spread the good word that we need to be strong enough to be able to help others.
Absolutely.
With that message, we can close this discussion. Thank you very much.
Sir, my pleasure. Thank you so much, sir.